Master, how may I assist?
Pitiful fool. I don't need one of you. I need an army.
Must help. Make clones.
Clones are a powerful tool for duplicating things in Scratch. But if you don't know how to properly control your new creations, things can quickly get out of hand. Vampire Survivors is an award-winning shooter where your character battles massive hordes of bloodthirsty monsters. Gamers have always loved chaotic shoot-em-ups like this, where enemies come at you from every direction and the screen is filled with destruction. But trying to code something similar can be a little tricky for new scratchers. The first approach a lot of my students try when making a complex game for the first time is to make a separate sprite for each object on the screen. This quickly gets very complicated. Every time you modify your code, you need to go back and make changes to every single sprite. To solve this problem, we're going to have to send in the clones. Clone is a temporary copy of a sprite that you can use anytime you need lots of something on the screen. Activating this block creates a clone right under your original sprite. Creating them in a loop lets you make up to 300 copies. They're temporary, which means they disappear after you hit the stop button.
Clean up Unit 12.
You can also command them to delete themselves with this block.
Clone deleted.
Let's just check on my nanobots.
Ordering clones around can get a little confusing until you understand how they work. Clones will ignore any commands you give under the green flag block. You can use this part of the code as a clone-making machine that spawns new enemies whenever you need them to appear. But once a clone is created, you usually use one of these blocks to tell it what to do. Your original sprite will ignore commands under the When I Started the Clone block, which is why it's usually best to avoid confusion by hiding the original sprite. Remember though, that an invisible sprite will create invisible clones. So the first thing your clone should do when it's created is to make itself visible again. Be very cautious if you're using a keyboard command to make new clones. Remember that the green flag block only works on your original sprite, and the When I Started the Clone block only works on clones. But other hat blocks work on both the original sprite and the clone. When I use a space key to create a new nanobot, everything works great the first time. But on my second key press, my clone is also making a clone. On every key press, your number of clones doubles, and before you know it, Scratch will hit the 300 clone limit and refuse to make any more. This problem shows up all the time when new Scratchers start coding their first shooting game. After a few shots, the player mysteriously runs out of ammo. Everything looks correct on the screen until you move your missiles around and see that each new projectile has been spawning copies of itself right underneath the original clone. Fortunately, there's a simple fix. Just move the shoot command to your ship sprite. Switch the pull-down menu so the block is creating missiles instead of clones of myself, and now you should have infinite ammo. Another quirk that comes up with clones sometimes is that Scratch doesn't give you an easy way to tell them apart from each other. Controlling clones is pretty straightforward when you want them all to behave the same way, But what if I want each one to behave a little differently? To give these clones their own identity, I need to stamp each of them with a unique name tag that will let me tell them apart from each other. Let's go ahead and create a variable called clone name. But before I hit the OK button, I need to click this option that creates our variable for this sprite only. This creates something called a local or private variable, a variable that can be seen by one sprite, but is invisible to all the other sprites in your project. What makes local variables incredibly useful when you're working with clones is that creating a copy of your sprite also creates a copy of your variable. In shooter games, you can use this feature to create a separate hit point variable for each of your enemies. Each clone starts its life with 3 hit points, but it's a different 3 hit points for each clone. So when I damage one ship, it's the only one that loses points. Back in our clone project, we can use this feature to stamp each of our clones with a different name. Just before we create our clone, let's insert a block that changes the value of our clone name to Carl. Before we create our next clone, we'll change the value of our variable to a new name and do that again for each clone. Each clone gets its own version of the clone name variable, and now each has its own identity. Now that we can tell them apart, I can use that unique identity in an if statement to give commands to just one of my clones.
Now I am an individual.
Of course, in your own projects, you're probably not going to need cute names for your clones. So the best approach is just to stamp each clone with an ID number and then increase that number by 1 every time you make a new clone. With your clone army finally under control, you're ready to take on the world.